There aren't many things as magnificent and mesmerizing as the Neolithic structures on the Orkney Islands. The main difference between the Orcadian monumental complex and the monumental complexes in other areas is the presence of the substantial settlement of Barnhouse and Brodgar Ness, which lie in the center of the surrounding monuments. When walking around the stone circle of Stenness, looking up at their towering height, one is struck by the sheer size and magnitude of the stones. The feelings of awe and wonder are a product of their architecture. My name is Katie. Join me in returning to mainland of the Orkney Islands in Scotland. This time, we will take a closer look at the oldest stone circle of the island, the stones of Stenness. Orkney is an archipelago in the Northern Isles of Scotland. It has about 70 islands, of which 20 are inhabited. The Orkney Islands have been inhabited for at least 8,500 years. First by the Mesolithic tribes, then the Neolithic farmers, and eventually the Picts. The inhabitants of Orkney are called Orcadians. In 875 AD, Orkney was colonized and later annexed by Norway, and eventually the Norse settled. The Stones of Stenness is one of four sites making up the heart of Neolithic Orkney and are listed as UNESCO World Heritage Sites. The other three are the Ring of Brodgar, Maes Howe, and Skara Brae. I've made a video about Skara Brae a while ago. I will link it in the description down below and I'll put a card in the upper right corner. Directly north of the standing stones, on just a 1 or 2 minute short walk, is a site known as the Neolithic Barnhouse Settlement, which we will cover later in this video. The Ring of Brodgar is only 1.2 kilometers to the northwest of the standing stones of Stenness, and Maes Howe Chambered Cairn is only 1.2 kilometers to the east of the stones. Located on the southeastern shore of the Loch of Stenness, the standing stones of Stenness might be the oldest henge monument on the British Isles. Though the site today lacks the encircling ditch and bank needed to be classified as a henge monument. Radiocarbon dating found at Stenness show as the oldest date 3350 BCE. This date comes from an animal bone they had found in the ditch of the monument. The ditch surrounding the stones had a diameter of 44 meters. The ditch enclosure had a single entrance to the north, facing the Neolithic Barnhouse settlement. During excavations in 1973 and 1974, they had found that the ditch was beneath the water table and kept filling with water. This, together with archaeological evidence of aquatic plants, indicate that while the monument was in use, the ditch contained water. This shows that water was a deliberate element of the design of the monument. Inside the ditch, they had found animal remains and pottery sherds. This could either indicate that offerings were thrown into the water of the ditch, or that the ditch was used to dump in the leftovers from the ceremonies inside the monument. But most bizarre was the fact that the archaeologists found two bones from a cremated human hand near the entrance causeway of the ditch. The pottery found at the stones of Stenness link the monument to both Skara Brae and Maes Howe Chambered Cairn. Originally, there were 11 stones in a circle of 32 meters in diameter. A 12th stone socket was found, but that has never been in use. The stones are thin slabs, approximately 30 centimeters thick, and have sharply angled tops. Four stones of up to 5 meters in height are original elements of this circle. In the center of the ring, there is a large stone hearth, similar to those found at Skara Brae. It's made up of four stone slabs. 140 meters north of the stones used to be the Odin stone. This stone held a special place in the tradition, customs, and lore of the Orcadian people. The Odin stone was best known for the part it played in sealing agreements, marriages, and unions. People from all over Orkney would travel to the stone to make their vows absolute by clasping hands through the hole and swearing the Odin oath. When visiting the stone, it was customary to leave an offering of food or ale, and newborn babies were passed through the hole in the belief that this would ensure them a healthy future. The Odin stone was thought to have been erected in 3000 BCE. It was about 2.5 meters in height and about 1 meter wide, and the hole was not in the center of the stone. The location of the Odin stone used to be unclear until May 1988, when archaeologists surveyed the area. They uncovered numerous socket holes and eventually found the socket of the Odin stone. A second socket was found next to the Odin socket, indicating that the Odin stone used to be one of a pair. Outside of the ring to the northwest is another stone known as the Watchstone. It's approximately 5.6 meters in height. The Watchstone used to be one of a pair as well, as in the 1930s the stump of a second stone was found. One of the first reliable descriptions of the stones of Stenness is by Bishop Richard Pocock. He visited Orkney in July of 1760. The description states that there were four standing stones, the stump of a fifth one was visible, and a very large broad stone laid near the center of the semicircle. Evidence of this and other descriptions was essential when an attempt was made to reconstruct the stones of Stenness. Because in 1814, the tenant farmer W. Mackay had waged an attack on the megaliths of Stenness. The stones played a major part in the Orcadian traditions, and therefore a large number of people visited the site throughout the year. According to Mackay, this was ruining his farmland, so he decided to take it upon himself and tear down the stones. He began by breaking the Odin stone, and although the monolith had stood for millennia, the destruction took less than a day. He then toppled stone 5 and obliterated stone 6. The native Orcadians were furious and various attempts were made to burn down his house. Sheriff Peterkin at the time described the destruction of the three stones as torn from the spot on which they had stood for ages and shivered to pieces. Action was then threatened in the sheriff court to restrain Mackay from breaking up further stones. Mackay admitted to pulling down the stones of the circle for purpose of strengthening the fields and said that he had intended that two or three of them should stand. Local antiquarian Ernest Marwick found out that a piece of the Odin stone had survived up until the 1940s. It was the whole segment of the stone, and it was used as a horse-powered mill shaft that moved around the parish of Stenness as the mill changed owners. When it was finally decided to replace the mill with a threshing machine, the old mill was uprooted and the piece of Odin stone gathered moss. One day, the owner's son decided to tidy up and remove the old machinery. Being unable to remove the stone segment and ignorant of its history, he smashed it to dust. With this action, he closed the chapter of Orcadian history, and now the Odin stone is completely gone. Novelist Sir Walter Scott had visited the site in 1814 and proclaimed that the stone slab at the center of the ring was probably the altar on which human sacrifices were made. In 1906, the toppled stone number 5 was re-erected. In 1907, they had also done some inaccurate reconstruction inside the circle. This included Scott's altar, a table-like dolmen structure in the center of the stone circle. Local talk was that the dolmen had no place inside the monument, so in 1972, the dolmen structure was toppled. Since there were doubts about its authenticity, archaeologists were called in to excavate around the base of the structure to find out whether there was any evidence on the altar's historical existence. Evidence was found that confirmed that some form of stone structure had indeed existed on that location within the circle. And even though the excavations were inconclusive, the two upright stones of the dolmen structure were re-erected, and the tabletop slab was left lying beside them, where it remains today. Following the destruction of the central dolmen, a 7-week excavation took place in the years 1973 and 1974. During these excavations, they dug a series of trenches around the monument, primarily to prove or disprove the dolmen's existence. They confirmed for the first time that the remaining stones had been part of a ring that contained at least 11 stones, with a 12th socket never being used. Geological examinations of the surviving stones revealed that 5 different types of stones were used in the construction of the monument. A discovery which ties in with Dr. Colin Richards' theory that the stones for the monument were brought to the site from various different, perhaps significant, locations. The same has been proven at the Ring of Brodgar. South of the Hearthstones, they found a group of pits, one of which contained charcoal dating between 469 AD and 669 AD. This find indicates that the stone circle had activity of perhaps a ritualistic nature well into the Iron Age and into the first millennium AD. What's known as the Barnhouse settlement are the remnants of an Orcadian Stone Age settlement which was inhabited between 3300 and 2600 BCE. The village was discovered in the winter of 1984 when archaeologist Colin Richards exercised a field walk. Its location is on the shore of Lough Haray, just 140 meters north of the Stones of Stenness. Over the centuries, a lot of agricultural activity had taken place, so little remained of the site, but the excavations uncovered evidence of 15 small dwellings in various stages of development. The structures were round, perhaps with timber and turf roofs, and turf cladding surrounded the outer walls. It appears that the barnhouse dwellings were freestanding and not encased in middens, as they lack the roofed passageways that we saw in Skara Brae. Particularly intriguing is the fact that each building seems to have been deliberately destroyed after the settlement fell out of use. Only the reconstructed lower sections of a couple structures of the village's stonework are visible today, but the similarities between Barnhouse and Skara Brae are obvious, which is not particularly surprising given the fact that the two villages were in use around the same time. But the Barnhouse structures do actually differ in style to those at Skara Brae. It's not a huge difference, and it's mostly due to the fact that the Barnhouse settlement fell out of use some 450 years before Skara Brae did. The architecture therefore didn't develop to the same extent, and the earlier dwellings at Skara Brae are most similar to the Barnhouse settlement. The similarities between the settlements are, they have the same central curved hearths, the recessed box beds, and the stone furniture. Two of the Barnhouse buildings are different from the rest, and as we've seen at Skara Brae, a village doesn't only consist of houses. These structures, known as House 2 and Structure 8, are larger and more elaborate than the other buildings and may hint at the ritualistic nature of the settlement. Unlike Skara Brae, where the houses had a uniform size and layout, the structures at Barnhouse seem to indicate a hierarchical society with a chief or religious leader overseeing the community's activities. House 2 is the larger, more elaborate house. The building was partitioned with stone slabs to form two chambers with six side recesses built into the interior wall. Each of the building's two chambers had a central hearth. A few feet from the main entrance, a stone cist was found in the floor which contained a number of human bones. The cist was covered by a triangular slab of stone and positioned in such a way that anyone entering the building had to pass over it. The architecture of the structure is similar to that of the chambered cairns found at Orkney, suggesting a symbolic link to the village's dead inhabitants or their ancestors. Because of this, it's thought that the structure was not just a residence, instead it appears to have been involved in rituals or ceremonies which were significant to the inhabitants of the village. Directly opposite of House 2 is Structure 8, which is the largest covered structure from Neolithic Orkney to date. It was built in 2600 BCE, after the settlement had already been abandoned. It was a massive hall-like structure, 7 meters across, with 3 meter thick walls. It was built on a platform of yellow clay, which was enclosed by a circular wall, creating an internal courtyard over 20 meters across. To access the central enclosure, the Neolithic visitor had to first walk through a 3 meter long entrance passage. A hearth was built into the floor of the passage, flanked by two standing stones. The hearth was most likely paved over, but its presence might be symbolic. Although it could have been a remnant of a foundation ceremony, which took place before the building got constructed. Inside, things were mostly the same as the smaller houses, with a large central hearth and stone dresser, similar to those found in almost all late Neolithic houses. The discovery of the dresser in Structure 8 proved to archaeologists that it was more than simply just furniture and probably had religious or ritual significance. During excavations, a complete grooved ware pot was found to have been set into the clay floor by the eastern wall. This pot was undecorated except for the rim, which was above ground and contained 14 flint nodules. A quantity that would have been regarded as a treasure hoard at the time, since flint was very scarce in Orkney. It seems that structure 8 indicates a change in the religious and ritual practices at the time. Before its construction, the ceremonies most likely would have taken place in the Henge of Stenes, open to the entire community. But after construction, it seems that the rituals and religious practices now took place inside this enclosed space, only accessible to a select few. During excavations at the Barnhouse settlement, they found hundreds of pieces of worked flint, 180 sherds of grooved ware, numerous burnt animal bones, two polished stone axes, stone knives, hammer stones, and a single piece of Arran pitch stone. The Barnhouse settlement has a standing stone, known as the Barnhouse stone, which is aligned with the watchstone in a direct line to the center of the Ring of Brodgar. We know that the settlement was in use at the same time as the standing stones of Stenes. Within the largest structure is a central hearth similar to the one in the center of the Stenes Henge. Was the settlement created to house certain individuals important to the construction of the stone ring? This might explain why the settlement was demolished after use. Another theory is that the village was constructed to house an elite class of priests. The ritualistic elements in the design of the Barnhouse settlement and its location in the ceremonial heartland of Neolithic Orkney gives way to this theory, as the stones of Stenes, the Ring of Brodgar, Mace Howe Chambered Cairn and the Ness of Brodgar are all visible from the Barnhouse settlement. I will be looking into Mace Howe, the Ring of Brodgar and the Ness of Brodgar in the future. Especially the Neolithic settlement known as the Ness of Brodgar is very high on my list, so be sure to stick around for that. But with that information, you have reached the end of the video. If you enjoyed watching, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you like to see more of these kind of videos. And click the bell icon to receive notifications every time I upload. If you haven't watched my previous videos, then click the card in the upper right corner or click the link to the playlist down below. And for now, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.